Hello everyone, my name is Imran. I'm working as a data scientist internship for the ASHOPS. And today I'm doing a video about Python programs for accessing Excel files and web scraping. So let's continue the program. And this is the first program for creating Excel files and adding some data into the Excel file. And we are using the pandas library for doing that and creating a dictionary of data called data. And here's the product. Product is the key, and these are all the values that are given: the laptop, phone, earphones, and the jacket. And this is another column called price that has the price columns. And I'm converting this data into a data frame using the pandas. Then the data frame is saved onto the Excel using the dot to Excel. And the Excel file, I'm naming it as new Excel file dot XLS. You have to give the extension. I'm giving the extension, and this is the sheet name. My sheet name. Then I'm running the program. Let's open the Excel file. Here's the Excel file, new Excel.file, new Excel file.xlx. And as you can see, here is the product and price. These are the values that are given in the program. And nextly, the second program, we'll see about the second program. And the second program is about the importing data from the Excel file. No, you have Excel file to import data using the Excel file using Python. Then we can use import pandas as PD and using the data frame, and then using a pandas to read the Excel file using it dot read Excel, and passing the file name new Excel file dot XLX. And this was a file that was previously created in a program. I'm importing it there, and these are the values in that Excel file. I'll run one second running. As you can see, just a second. As you can see, these are the files present in the Excel file called new Excel file.xlx. And the next program we're talking about is the formatting data in Excel. You're formatting the data that are present in the Excel file with the help of a library called XLX writer. Creating an Excel file called workbook. It initializes a workbook known as personal info.xlx. We're giving extension as .xlx because it's an Excel file. We are adding a worksheet called a details sheet. And adding the cell format, setting the bold, setting the font size as a bold is equal to 2, and the font color is setting it as blue. Then you are setting the font size as the 16, and you are setting the alignment as a center. So we're writing as A1 column. That's the first column in when you're opening the Excel sheet, and you're naming it as the name, and this is using a cell format. Your cell format is bold set to true, and the font color is the blue. And you're also passing another column at B1 called mobile number, and using the cell format. Your cell format is the same as a bold is set to true, and the font color is blue. You're setting the row is equal to 1, using a variable row and column, and you're passing a data. This is the data that are present, person 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the numbers. These are the dummy numbers. These are the names that you want to give for this name column of this person 1, person 2, person 3, 4 names. And these are the dummy mobile numbers that are passed to the mobile number columns. And setting the column as B1 to B1. And this is the size of the column or the width of the column. Okay. This is the width of the column. And I'm setting, and I'm running a loop so that we are writing this data, the present in the data variable, into the worksheet. That's our Excel sheet I'm writing. Then I'm saving it as, and I'm closing my workbook as dot with the help of workbook.close. As you can see, this I saved as my personal file as personal file. I'll show for the personal file, personal info.xlx. And as you can see, here are the data that I passed, person 1, person 2, person 3, 4, and the dummy mobile numbers. And the next program we're gonna see about is the Excel charts. How we can draw Excel charts in Excel using Python and using a library called import open PyExcel. And using the bar charts, first we're gonna for creating a bar chart, I'm using importing a bar chart can reference from the open Excel library dot charts. And the importing as well as line chart and area chart from the OpenPyExcel.chart. and you are creating a workbook, initializing a workbook using the OpenPy Excel. Then you are creating a create sheet. Now I'm creating three sheets, namely bar one. One is the bar sheet, and secondly the line chart, and the third sheet is named as area chart. Okay. Then I'm writing some integers or some data from 0 to 9, depending to the this the WS1. That WS1 is the first worksheet called as bar chart. Okay. Then I'm using a reference for, you know, minimum columns are set to 1, a minimum row is set to 1, max column is 1, max row is 10. I'm creating a bar chart, initializing a bar chart to a variable called chart. I'm adding a data to the values. These are the values that I created here, 0 to 9, that I appended in the WS1. Then I'm setting the title as bar chart for the sheet 1, and the x-axis title as the x-axis, and the y-axis title as the y-axis. Okay. Then I'm adding this chart that I've created now into the Excel file, in the E5 column. It should start from the E5 column. So the next chart is that this is for the line chart. So this will be in the next chart, next sheet. So I'm creating a values of 0 to 9 and appending it to the WS2, which is my, I'm creating a variable here. Because WS2 is for my line chart. Okay. Then WS chart, also initializing a line chart with the same variable chart. Then adding data values, then having setting the title as a line chart and the x-axis title as a x-axis. I'm setting as a y-axis title as a y-axis. Then I'm adding this chart same as the E5 column, but in this will be present in the sheet 2. Okay. Now this is same as a above. I'm doing it for the same thing, but you're plotting an area chart in the sheet number 3, known as a area plot or area chart. Okay, adding the same value. But initializing the title as area chart and the x-axis as x-axis, y-axis, title as y-axis. I'm adding the chart, initializer chart is equal to area chart. This initialization, we're adding the data to the same E5 column, but it's present in the sheet 3. And this I shared as the Excel charts.xlx. I have to give the extension for that. And here is the Excel charts.xlx. Just a second. As you can see, this is a bar chart. This is a sheet 1. Sheet 2 and sheet 3. In sheet 1, this is another bar chart as a dummy variables that you have created from 0 to 9. And this is the bar graph. As you can see, it rises exponentially. And the next one is a line chart. This is a line chart for the same dummy variables. And this is one is a area chart for the same data values. And the next program we're going to talk about is extracting mobile number from a PDF. Okay, we are extracting mobile numbers that are present in a PDF, and we are using the library regular expression known as RE, and you're reading the PDF file. I'm using PyPDF2 library. Now reading a PDF that I'm reading my resume in the form of PDF that is present in the form of PDF, and reading it as reading mode. So I'm getting RB, and RB is nothing but read bytes. I'm initializing the PDF reader PDF file reader. I'm passing the file object that's going to open my resume in the form of PDF. I'll show you my resume in the form of PDF. Okay, just a second. As you can see, this is present in the PDF format, and here's the number present here. Okay, then after passing that, I'm setting a pattern using regular expression, which finds the numbers. Mobile numbers present in the PDF file. I'm using that, passing the PDF file here. Then I'm printing the matches. Then I'm closing the PDF file. As you can see, this is the number present. This is my number present in the my resume. Then is the same exciting mobile number, but you are using the docs format instead of PDF format. You have a file present in the docs format. You can extract mobile number as well from the docs file. For this, for reading docs file, I'm using a docs2 text library, and I'm using pandas as well. And the next thing is that docs2 process. I'm reading the docs file here as well. I'm passing my resume in the form of docs file. Then I'm using a regular expression for reading the numbers. Then I'm using a pattern search to find the numbers. So I'm passing my docs file that is initialized in a my text variable. I'm printing the numbers. This is my numbers present in the docs file I'll show you the docs file. As you can see, this is my resume in the form of docs format. So this is finding my number present here. As you can see, I'll zoom in. This number is being printed in the program. This is found out by the Python program that I've written here. So yeah, these are the numbers that are present in my docs format. Okay, next program. Then the next one is, just a second, I'll show you the next one. And finally, you're seeing about the web scraping. Web scraping is nothing but extracting data from the websites. And you're using a regular expression from import, regular expressions. And you're using a URL lib.request to read the web URLs. And you're importing URL open and the request function methods from the URL library. And using a beautiful soup for arranging the elements. Then you're using a taking input from the user to take the web, you're asking him to paste the web page link that you want to scrap. You have to include even HTTPS, okay, at the start. And you're running a try except block. If it runs into your expression, your any found expression, you're using request.webpage, then passing a URL, okay. The printing web page is currently being scrapped because of when the program files, this will be being printed when the process is going on in the back end. Okay, then the using beautiful soup to know using HTML parser to the pass the files that are present in the HTML. Okay, then getting the text, getting the text present in the HTML using the website using .getText method. Once you're getting the text, we are finding, we're setting the regular expression to find the emails present. These are the W and the direct sign to. You're passing the scrap, this is the tags, and this is finding all the emails present in this scrap. Okay, so the scrap is nothing but the web URL. Once it finding the emails, it is finding the length of the how many emails are found. The length is being found and set to the variable called total email. That emails are now converted as a list file. Once you're converting the list file, if my email length is zero, okay. If no emails are found in the web URL, they are passing the message called as no email address found. Or else, if the count is the number of how many email addresses that many numbers will be printed here, email addresses found. Then the total email. For example, you are finding teacher's email address from a web URL. For example, this is a website which provides as a dummy emails. So these are the emails, dummy emails present here, as you can see. And I'm passing the same websites here as my input. Just a second, I'll run the program. If this is masking for my input, the page, the web page you would like to scrap, include HTTPS. Okay, I'm passing the website, I'm pressing enter. As you can see, website is currently being scrapped. So it's once it scraps, it prints the email address. This is the first email address that being found. This is the second one. Similarly, 10 email addresses are being found in the URL. Then as foxci.com/fake-emails-list. Once I'm found, it uses the total number of emails that are being passed. So there are 10 emails that are being scrapped from the website that are given as an input. So these are the programs that have been taught here. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you.